Shalom. First off, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem, Rechak, Wadash. Yahweh is the Heavenly Father's true name in ancient Hebrew. Yahweh Shai is the name of His only begotten Son, Savior of the nation of Israel, starting with the elect, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And the Rechak, Wadash is the Holy Spirit that gives us the inspiration to feed the sheep and to comfort us in these evil days. All right, double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone, who I learned the truth from. Honest salutations and blessings to the men that are preaching the gospel of Yahweh Shai in all sincerity, diligence, and truth. And to the men, women, and children that staying in the Holy Spirit and keeping the faith of Yahweh Shai to the best of their ability day in and day out. All right, so this lesson is going to be, you know, about faith, okay, which is, you know, the main ingredient, the main, you know, substance that you need in order to, first and foremost, please the Heavenly Father Yahweh through His Son Yahweh Shai, you know, and also to endure, okay? You have to have faith, okay? So, you know, the title is going to be Hope to Come, okay? Because the faith that we have is that we have hope to come, all right? Because we don't have hope in this world, all right? In this age, all right? In this current you know, system, there's no hope. There's no hope for us, man. We're looking for the constellation of Israel, all right? We're looking for the restoration of Israel, which can only come by our Lord and our Savior, Yahweh Shai, all right? It's not going to come by, you know, some man. It's not going to come by, you know, so-called black people coming together, all right, and building up the community, all right? There's only one way for the restoration, for the restoring, for the constellation of Israel to happen here, all right, on earth, all right? It's going to be by way of the King of Kings, all right? Our Lord, our Redeemer, all right, whose name, true name and only name that you can call on to be delivered is Yahweh Shai. All right. And this is what we believe, man. Okay. And we get persecuted for this belief. All right. We get, you know, ridiculed. We get mocked. We get people, you know, cast our names out as evil for believing on the Son of Man. Well, you know, that just, you know, shows that, Lord willing, we are those men, because the Lord created certain spirits. All right. Certain spirits were created to wait on Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. All right. That's just what they were created to do, because the Lord are going to use those spirits that wait on Him to show His mercy, okay? Those spirits that wait on the Lord are going to be the vessels of mercy, okay? And, you know, that's why we have to continue to wait, not to lose patience, not to be weary, because the wait that we have, the hope, the faith that we have has a great reward of recompense, okay? So this is Acts 26, start at 6, says, And now I stand, this is Paul speaking during his, you know, his judicial hearing, okay, because Paul got locked up for this very same hope, all right? He got persecuted for this very same hope, all right? And these are, you know, things that are written aforetime for our learning, so that when these things happen to us, we don't, you know, be soon shaken in spirit. We don't be, afraid, man, because these things are going to happen, that we're going to get persecuted simply because of the hope that we have, all right? And our hope is not in this world, all right? But our hope is in the world to come, all right? So it says, and now I stand and am judged for the hope of the promise made of our power unto our fathers, unto which promise our 12 tribes, okay? So this promise was made to our fathers, the patriarchs, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, exclusively, okay? It's not into everybody. It's not into all nations, all families, all tribes. It's only to the 12 tribes, man, all right? And even within those 12 tribes, you have certain Israelites that don't have this hope, okay? That's why the scriptures, you know, that's why the scriptures talks about the children of Abraham by faith, because truly, it's through faith that we, you know, that we are part of the hopeful elect, okay? It's through faith that that the elect will be delivered, okay, which is a gift from the Most High. We are saved by grace through faith, which is a gift of the Most High, not of yourselves, okay? So that's why you have people that come up against us, because they don't understand our faith, man. They don't understand, and they can't get it, all right? Even if they wanted to, if the Lord didn't preordain you to have faith, all right, you might hear this word and you might, you know, it might excite you, Okay, but if you're not rooted and established in Yahweh Shai, which is through faith, then ultimately you're not going to endure. All right? You're not going to endure. So it says, until which promise our 12 tribes instantly serving the Most High day and night hope to come. For which hope's sake, King Agrippa, I am accused of the Jews. You see that? So it says instantly, which means earnestly. Because you have those men, all right, starting with the 144,000. Let me get that. Starting with the 144,000, those men, the Lord set it up in their spirits to, no matter what, have this faith, man, throughout the generations. Okay, that's why Yahweh Shai said that they, you that have followed me in the regeneration, okay, when the Son of Man cometh, sit upon his throne, shall also, you know, sit upon 12 tribes, 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes. And not just starting with the 12 disciples, apostles, but also the ones, the rest of the 144. They have followed Yahweh Shai through the regenerations, man. Since the beginning of time. That's why Yahweh Shai said what? That you have been with me from the beginning. Okay? Because we've had that hope. Okay? We've had that hope from the beginning of the promise, which the Lord put it in to certain spirits. Once again, he created certain spirits with faith, man. Okay? He created certain spirits to have this faith. And this is why you cannot let the things of this world, you know, make you wavering, man. You can't let the persecution and the tribulation of this world snatch that faith from you. Because once you lose faith, what does the scripture say? Woe unto him that have lost patience, what shall you do? Okay, when in the day of visitation. Because the Lord is not going to deliver somebody that doesn't believe that the Lord can deliver them. All right, or that is not waiting for the Lord to deliver them. All right. So it says Revelation 14, verse, I'm going to start at 1 and I'm going to jump. It says, and I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000. And with him, that's the 144,000, man, the 12,000 from each tribe. You can read about that in Revelation, the 7th chapter, okay, 1 on down, okay? It says, having the Father's name written in their foreheads, okay? The Father, Yahweh, through his Son, Yahweh Shai. Those names are written in our foreheads, meaning what? It's always on our mind, man, okay? Sealed. It's always on our mind because that's where we know our faith lies, all right? That's where we know our hope lies. And we believe on the promise that the Heavenly Father gave unto us, all right? The Almighty Creator, Yahweh, all right? He exists, made a promise unto our forefathers, man, that Israel shall be saved with an everlasting salvation, okay? A world without end, dominion, inheritance of the earth, okay? Immortality, blessed above all nations. This is what the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, promised unto us, man. And this is what we believe on. This is what we have faith. This is the hope that is to come. Because obviously, the Lord didn't manifest that promise yet. Clearly, we're still in captivity. Clearly, we're at the bottom. Clearly, we still die. Okay, so that hope is still yet to come, but the Lord has given that promise is yet to come. But the Lord has given the faith to men, all right, certain men to believe on that promise, and that's why the scripture says we walk by faith and not by sight. Okay, so I'm gonna jump verse 4. It says, "These are they which were not defiled with women." Okay, that woman is not speaking about an actual woman. Okay, but it's speaking about the philosophies, you know, the dogma of this world, all right? The adultery or the idolatry or the fornication spiritually against Yahweh, okay? Because if you lack faith, or if you don't believe in a hope to come, what do? All right, if you're not faithful, if you're an infidel, right? If a person is an infidel, speaking on a carnal level, what do? They sleep, you know, a woman sleeps around with other men, okay? A man, if he has a woman, all right, he does what? He'll sleep around with, another man's wife, okay? Because a man can have multiple women, but that's neither, you know, that's another topic for another time. But it says these are which are not defiled with women, for they are virgins, These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits of the Most High and to the Lamb. So these are the ones that's going to be redeemed among men. Okay? Meaning what? Brought back unto Yahweh through his son Yahweh Shai. All right? Because they are virgins. They are pure. Because what makes you pure? It's not, obviously, it's not of your works. All right? It's of your faith. Okay? Wherein ye are saved. Okay? Ephesians 2 and 8. It's through your faith you are saved. And that's what makes you pure, because the Lord's only coming for the pure, man. He's only, and that's through Yahweh Shai, the blood of the unblemished lamb. Right? So let me now jump to this. Psalms 27, verse 12. It says, Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, starting chiefly with Esau, Edom. All right, for false witnesses are rise up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. Okay, false witnesses. When you go into Revelation, the 12th chapter, it tells you that when Yahweh Shai comes back, he's going to destroy the accuser of our brethren, all right, which accused us day and night before our Father, man, which is who? The false witnesses, Esau, okay? The devil, the Satan adversary. That's what he does, man. Okay? He's our enemy. Verse 13. It says, I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. All right? You see that? I have fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of Yahweh in the land of the living. And that's why you have a lot of people who faint, man. But the scripture tells you not to be faint-hearted. Because you faint because you truly don't believe on a hope to come. You don't believe on the promise, man. You don't believe that we're going to be redeemed, that we're going to have everlasting life, that this is not our rest, okay? That's why people get disenchanted when tribulation arises, all right? Or when things, you know, when things don't happen on their time, they get disenchanted because they don't truly believe on the hope to come. They don't believe on the power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right? It says, I have fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on Yahweh. Be of good courage. All right? That's being strong. You got to be strong in faith, man. The weak-minded, all right, the ones who are weak faith, they're not going to endure. You got to have strong faith. That's why you got to pray. For what? More faith, man. Okay? You got to pray for more faith, because that's what's going to keep you rising up and pushing, man, and persevering. Wait on Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Wait comes with what? Patience. That's why Yahweh Shai said what? In your patience, possess ye your souls. Okay? It's all about patience. The faith and the patience. Hey, let me get that scripture real quick. It tells you, here is the faith and the patience of the saints. The ones who truly are, you know, the true worshipers of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, Revelation 13, verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints. All right, so this is something else that the saints, the holy ones, okay, of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, are waiting for, man. We're waiting for retribution. We're waiting for revenge, man, which is going to come by way of Yahweh sending his son back, Yahweh Shai. He is the avenger of his kinsmen. Okay, he is the avenger, man, of the blood of the saints, and with that, he's going to also give us a two-edged sword to get vengeance on our enemies, man. But we have to have patience in that. You have a lot of men that lose that patience. And when they lose that patience, they either become what? Cold. All right. They either, you know, just go back and join back into the world, or they try to, make something happen on their own accord, man. All right. And not waiting on the Lord. And what that ends up happening is what? Either way, you end up getting destroyed. Okay. That's why you got to have the faith and you got to have the patience. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints, is that we know and have faith and believe that the Lord is going to give us the next of our enemies, man. He is going to deliver us out of this place. He's going to restore Israel, okay? And once the Lord sets us up, no man is going to be able to come up against us, right? So let me get a few more and I'm gonna close it out. All right, this is just a couple of cross references to wait on the Lord and be of us. Let me finish that. Wait on Yahweh and be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart, their mind. All right, wait, I say, on Yahweh. So your mind is strengthened by having faith, man, by being of a good courage, by waiting. All right, your mind is strengthened. And the way you get that strength is by what? Praying, and also by going back into the Comforter, which is the scriptures, man. Okay, through the Holy Spirit. Waiting, reading these things, hearing these words gives you the strength, man, to endure. All right, that's why it's important to stay embedded in these scriptures. Because your mind can't give you your own strength, man. This world is definitely not going to give you the peace of mind. But the Lord said what? In me, you should have peace. In this world, you're going to have tribulation. Okay? And what? And the Lord said, I come in a volume of the book. So we got to read this book, okay, in the spirit, in order to what? Get that strength in the mind, all right? So a few more. This is our Revelation, Psalms 25, verse 3. It says, yeah, let none that wait on thee be ashamed. Let them be ashamed which transgress without cause. So none of the ones who wait on the Lord are going to be ashamed. That's why the scripture says that Israel shall never be ashamed, okay? But what? But should be saved with an everlasting salvation. Because once we get delivered, all right, the Lord is going to make good on his promise, man. The Lord put his name on us, man. He put his name on Israel. So that's why he says, for my name's sake, I shall deliver you, okay? So we're not going to be ashamed, because the Lord is not going to let his name go tarnished throughout his creation, throughout eternity, throughout time. No, he's going to redeem his people, because he put his name on his people. All right. Psalms 37, verse 7. Rest in Yahweh and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prosper in the way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. You see? So we rest in the Lord, man, because this is not our rest. But we're laboring now to enter into that rest, which is an everlasting rest. And not just us, but the men that have been before us, man. Okay? The cloud of witnesses. All right? They believed and they earnestly desired to serve the Lord, because they had so much faith in the promise to come, man. Okay? That's what another thing is. True men of the Lord are going to look and hasten into that day, to the hope to come. Because in here, in this place, we don't have any hope, man. There's nothing. This is just a fucking hamster wheel cycle, day after day, doing the same bullshit, okay? And time is passing, and if Paul said, if in this life we only had hope, we are men most miserable, man. But no, we look into what? The life to come, the age to come, man. The age of Israel, which Yahweh Shai is going to bring. And that's why the prophecies are so important, because those things cannot come to pass unless the prophecies be fulfilled. See, this is why we measure the time diligently, because a lot of people, they get disenchanted because they just seeing them like, oh, nothing's happening. All right, 2 Peter, the third chapter, all things continue as they were. But no, the men of the Lord, they're measuring the times through the prophecy. And that's how we know that what? Our time, our redemption is nigh, man. That's why you got to understand these prophecies. Everything is moving at the rate of the prophecies, man. Okay. And we see that these last prophecies are right around the corner. Okay. The mark of the beast, the day of Armageddon. Okay. Which is going to and bring in what? The nuclear destruction of Babylon, America the Great, Babylon the Great, which is America. All right. So fret not because of him who prosper in the way. So we don't fret because Esau is prospering, man. We're seeing the downfall of his prosperity. All right. This golden cup. Okay. America is becoming a shit show, man. All right. So all these things that we have joy in, because we understand the prophecies that comes with it. All right. We understand the prophecies and what comes with it, which is the hope to come. All right. Psalm 62, verse 5. My soul, wait thou only upon the Most High, for my expectation is from him. All right. Our expectation is from Yahweh, man. We don't expect this devil to give us reparations. We don't expect Israelites to come together underneath some movement. All right. Underneath some Black Lives Matter or some community togetherness. No, man. That's why we know that only the elect is going to get this, and the elect are going to hear the word, the shepherd's voice, Yahweh Shai, and they're going to wait also, man. Okay, that's it. Nothing else, man. And the Lord is going to give us our expectation, man. All right, He's going to give us. He knows what He's going to give us an expected end, and our expected end is to be what, sitting upon those thrones, judging the 12 tribes, judging the world, man. All right, as the scripture says, that the saints shall judge the world, everlasting life, new bodies, incorruptible. That is our expectation, and that can only come from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna end it there. You know, there's a lot more. All right, you know, I would suggest reading these scriptures, man, about hope, man, about faith, because this is what we should do, man. Hey, let me get this. Lamentations 3 verse 26. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. All right. So, you know, meditate on that, man. All praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Shalom.